effort. CDSE. First is effort. Nothing in life can be achieved without effort. Even effortlessness is achieved only through effort. If you ever see somebody is able to do something effortlessly, then you should understand how much effort should have gone in. When Ustad Zakir Hussain is effortlessly playing the magic of his tabla, you should understand what sort of effort has gone into it. When you are engrossed into a trance listening to Pandit Ravi Shankar, you should understand what sort of effort has gone into it. Without effort, even to sit in the seat of silence, a state of non-doing, a lot of effort is required to bring you to that stage. Didn't we learn very early in life in our nursery rhyme? Row, row, row your boat. Simply sitting in the boat, you row, row. And row, row, row your boat, not others' boat. All the time thinking about whether Dhoni will score 100, Hrithik Roshan's movie will be a hit or not, whether Vishwanath Anand will win the chess championship or not. All the time we can be interested in the success of everybody. But understand, your success is your success. Other success is not your success. An Indian cricket team winning can be a great source of celebration to all of you. It's still not the victory of this Indian who is sitting here. Now, I feel very good about you that you feel proud about what India achieves. But I think you should ask this question. What am I doing that India will be proud of? The Indian is proud of India. How am I living my life in a way that India can be proud of this Indian? What is your contribution to the progress of this nation? What is your contribution to the beginning of a new future? What is your contribution? Row, row, row your boat. Everything can be a distraction and an entertainment to you, but the focus of your life has to be your success. Things can give you a change of mind, but eventually if you don't focus in the becoming of you, you contribute nothing. How long will we be mere celebrators in life? You got to be the cause for celebration. You should be the instrument of that progress. Effort is required. Without effort, nothing can be achieved. And Rajan, this effort, it says self-motivated effort. Not externally motivated effort. It has to be a self-motivated effort. If mummy has to wake you up so that you will study, you can be sure you're not a school topper. If somewhere somebody has to wake you up every day for you to exercise, you can be sure about it, you're not super fit. When papa's in town, you'll always go to time on work. When papa goes out of station, you're still sleeping till 2 o'clock. Chota Seth, you will have to go and tell the world, it's only after I took over the family business, we are earning in lakhs. Before that, they used to earn in crores. As long as you want somebody to push you, you are still a follower in life. It's only when you are willing to push yourself, there's leadership in your life. Self-motivated effort. In the initial stages, all of us go through, we need somebody to believe in us. We need somebody beyond a stage. You got to be self-motivated. It says you do not get in life what you desire. You only get in life what you deserve. And for your desires to become deservingness, you have to back it up with consistent, directed, self-motivated direction. We cannot be a wandering generality. We have to be a meaningful, specific. What do you want to do with your life? Focus is not only my ability to say yes to the one, but also the discipline to say no to the 99 distractions. The man who chases two rabbits will miss both. What do you want to do? Without giving a direction to your self-motivated effort, you're mistaking activity for accomplishment. I can put in a lot of effort. I want to come and hug one of you in the front row. I can put in a lot of self-motivated effort. I'll stay here only. Unless I give myself a direction. What do you want to be? Where do you want to be? What do you want to accomplish? What if you do, will you feel accountable to the potential within you? In what direction you want to run the stream of your life? Directed self-motivated effort. Consistent directed self-motivated effort. Swami Vivekananda said, anybody can perform an occasional act of greatness. Truly great are those who can consistently perform acts of greatness. It is not about what you can do once in a way, it's what you can do always. Hamesha. It's only by bringing in that consistency. Consistency is the hallmark of greatness. And it is when you bring in that consistent, directed, self-motivated effort on your desires, you transform your desires into deservingness and thereby create the monumental possibilities of your life. So one, in that futuristic direction of what I build my life, I will expand the bandwidth of my perception. I will renew my perception about myself. I will remind myself my future need not be just a replica of my past. My future is not equivalent to my past. I can let go of the caterpillar within me and be the butterfly that I can be. I'm going to expand the bandwidth of my perception. I'm going to consistently remind myself I can. And I'm going to transform myself from I can't into I can through can I, consistent and never-ending improvement. How? Through small beginnings, incremental improvement, sustained progress, knowing it will create monumental possibilities. And how will I sustain my progress? By ensuring on my desires of life, I will always insist on consistent, directed, self-motivated effort. Translate my desires into deservingness and thereby encompass one day at a time the future I deserve to experience, I deserve to live in life. It seems a lady who was reading a scripture, someone read in the scripture, he, the silversmith, throws a piece of metal into a furnace and he watches. She could not understand what did the scripture mean when it said, he, the silversmith, throws a piece of metal into a furnace and watches. So she decided to see a silversmith at work and believed that she will be able to understand the relevance of the whole thing. So she went to see a silversmith at work, and sure enough, he took a piece of metal, put it into the furnace, and he was watching. She asked him, that's all? He said, yes. Why you have to keep watching? He said, if I don't keep watching, it'll get burnt. I should know when to take it out. Only then it'll become a glittering silver. So it is my responsibility to throw it into the furnace and keep watching till it becomes a glittering silver. That's when the lady realized, he, the silversmith, called God, throws you and me a piece of metal into the furnace called life, not for us to get burnt, for us to get created from a piece of metal into a glittering silver. Every experience that we go through in life is not burning us as a metal, but is transforming us and purifying us to become that glittering silver. So curious she was that she immediately asked, how will you know when you can take it out? The silversmith smiled and said, when I can see myself in it, I will take it out. When I know it becomes so glittering, I can see myself in it, I will take it out. That's when the lady realized, God became man. And through the process of life, there is this potential for man to transform himself once again into God. Every religion and every path of spirituality is telling you and me as individuals, you have descended from the divine and you can go through this enormous process of self-purification and self-transformation and become divinity personified once again in your life. If the spiritual goal and the spiritual possibility is God became man for man to become God again, should it be such a big struggle for all of us in the materialistic pursuit of life of what we can achieve and what we can accomplish. It is a never-ending process of man by his own awareness, watching himself, transforming himself, grooming himself to the possibility of what he can be. A very simple exercise, which has been an enormous scope of transformation, personally to me and to hundreds of thousands of lives who have walked this path, has been this process of practicing introspection at the close of every day. How every experience of life can be translated into a teacher of life from which we can groom in life. It's a very simple process. End of every day, just before you go to sleep, do not lie down, sit down, and just run through the entire events of your day. In your own mental projector, just create a march past of all the events that you have gone through in your life. Because what happens, my dear? We keep on accumulating knowledge at one end. We keep living our life at another end. We are not bridging knowledge with life. How often you and me have gone through these experiences. Before the incident, we know what to do. After the incident, we know what we should have done. During the incident, our own knowledge betrays us. You knew so much that no point in getting angry. Anger does not solve anything in life except increasing your BP. After the incident, you realize you shouldn't have got angry. Yet during the incident, your entire maturity betrayed you. That is why, ironically, a lot of us will find what all we know is actually helping others to grow much more than ourselves. We are great counselors of other people. Any problem anybody has, we can solve it for them. Only when it comes to us, we know it before the incident, we lack that context sensitivity of knowledge. And what will develop that context sensitivity of knowledge, bridging the past, the present, and the future, is by practicing introspection at the end of every day. Look at the magic of a very simple tool which Vedas gives us. Simply sit at the end of the day, run through your entire day. You're reliving your past, which is your today. It's already happened and done with. And you're reliving your entire past in the present. You're just reliving every moment. Okay, I got up in the morning, I went into the bathroom, and I found the paste was at one end and the cap was at the other end. I screamed in the morning. How many times I've told you people? During the introspection, you realize, for such a small thing, why did I disturb the peace of mind of everybody in the family? I could have just closed it and kept it. Rajan, if I keep closing it and keep it, when will they learn? Suppose they don't learn in a lifetime, you will die of BP. Might as well close the paste and keep it there. In fact, your son is so frustrated with you, he intentionally keeps it open and goes and sleeps. Keep it closed. I have a very, very strong feeling about all of you who can be easily provoked into anger. I'm sorry, I don't want to hurt you, but truth be told, I can provoke a dog into barking whenever I want. If I do, it will start barking. It's an animal. It does not have the intelligence to understand, Jaan pooch ke, he is provoking me, I should not bark. 100 times I can provoke the dog, it will start barking. If anybody in the world can provoke you into anger whenever they want, what are we? What are we? Who is the master of our emotions? If all you have to do is come and do something at the end of the program to me, and I get angry for the next half an hour, what am I? Speaker, that's all. Nothing more than a speaker. Somehow can keep on delivering speeches, but there'll be no validation of what I speak and what I live. If the message and the messenger is not one and the same, he doesn't have the right to speak on life. He doesn't have the right to speak on life. It's even this is now additional piece of knowledge. Before the incident, you'll know. After the incident, right now on your way back, one scooter fellow should cross your car. You'll get provoked. That, after the incident, you'll realize. Now, at least till today, you were peacefully angry. From today, you can't be peacefully angry because after you get angry, you'll remember this incident. Ush bol diya, main gussa ho gaya. What am I? Introspection will help you today. The most beautiful thing about introspection is this. Today you realize, I need not have shouted. Look at it. A past is analyzed in the present and a futuristic context is created. The most beautiful moment is not today. Tomorrow when you see the paste at one end and the cap at the other end, the moment you take it and you're about to shout, your inner voice will tell you, yesterday you said you will not shout, slowly you will close the cap and keep it. You have created a futuristic context to the whole thing. And I'll tell you, the most beautiful thing is not when you close the paste. Tomorrow night when you practice introspection, you'll realize, okay, I got up in the morning, paste was this side, cap was that side, and I didn't shout. A smile will automatically come inside you, and it's worth everything in life. It's worth everything in life. Because nothing like self-appreciation. In fact, our craving to be appreciated in the world automatically vanishes when there is enough self-appreciation in the world. Because you are not appreciating yourself enough, you want endorsement from the world. Even when you know you have done a fabulous work, you know what you have cooked is tasty. And yet you serve that food to the husband and keep on breathing long breaths. Basically, you're telling him, Bolna, acha hai. But that fellow is busy eating. If it's not good, he would have already told you. If it is good, that's his karma yoga. Where he will see on another direction. But when you start self-appreciating yourself, you don't need anybody to appreciate you in life. You know what you're doing. And the most beautiful thing about introspection is that you received coffee from the mother, reading the newspaper, and she went. You treated her like a coffee vending machine. She's a human being with full of emotions, a lady who has been waking up earlier than all of you in the family, sleeping the last for decades together, and she deserves. Mama, coffee super. Rajan, my mother's coffee is always good. So you think I should always appreciate her? Yes, because when it's not good, you always criticize her. If you think you have the right to criticize her always, you have the responsibility to appreciate her always. You have to say it. And you know, that is how you make her recognize that she is human. Of course, if you introspect today and tomorrow you take that coffee and tell mommy coffee is extraordinary, for a moment she might faint also because she has not heard that for years together. Might be a first time experience for her. You're driving on the way to work, an entire day ahead, important meetings. You get angry on the road, road rage. You shout at the cyclist. You scream at the rickshaw wala. Why are you burning so much emotions on the road? What, you're transforming the road? By you shouting at anybody, has anything changed? Except you build that entire temper and the temper will show up in the course of the day. Accept it and move on. On the road, it's not the question of whose mistake. You have to maneuver through the limitations of the road and keep going. Move on. There is a larger picture waiting for you. Now when I tell you, you will not understand. In introspection, you will realize. Whole half an hour of driving, I was angry at somebody on the road. I was angry at my own driver. In fact, you hire a driver by paying 8,000 rupees salary. So that you don't have to go through the stress on the road and you keep driving the driver. green ho gaya, chal. He can't see. Lorry, he cannot see. I can understand one snake on the road is going, he didn't notice, you noticed. Lorry, he cannot see. You pay him 8,000 rupees, you gave him the best seat in the car, which is driver's seat. You keep sitting behind and keep begging him, AC thoda bada karna. You're at his mercy. And then you're also stressed by driving the driver. Let him drive now. You sit and practice vipassana. Listen to some good music. Open your laptop and do something else. Watch the circus in the road. Enjoy the circus and go. Your grandfather in a bullock cart was more peaceful, and in a Toyota Corolla, you're stressed. All this you will clap. Go and sit in Toyota Corolla and get upset about the driver. Han marna, han. He knows. He is also not interested in dying. But introspection will reveal this to you. So much you will learn. The processes of leadership that you can improve. Because the peace with which you sit at the end of the day, just run through your day. And the most beautiful thing of introspection is, not only it's creating the context of self-appreciation, it's also creating the context of self-criticism. Because you are criticizing yourself, you are not ego involved. If there is one process that links the past that has already happened, the present in which you are reviewing that past, and creating a futuristic perspective on the maturity with which I live my tomorrow. And the beauty about introspection is, tonight when you practice introspection, please, no matter what about the speech you will implement, research show what you don't implement within 48 hours of deciding never gets implemented. Never gets implemented. Which means something about these 2 hours, if it is not implemented within 48 hours, you have some more knowledge. And that is how we have become the knowledge capital of the world. Lot of knowledge. Information technology, no transformation technology. But there has to be transformation. Very important. And I really think introspection is a beautiful place to begin practicing introspection. You will realize by practicing introspection, after 10 o'clock till 2 o'clock, what did I do? You won't be able to recall. You lived like a stranger to your own life. The most beautiful thing that you could not recall from 10 o'clock to 2 o'clock today will be shown tomorrow. Tomorrow you live your life with greater awareness. Because you know at the end of the day, you have to review the day. You'll remember whatever happens. Your awareness grows up. Introspection, self-appreciation, introspection, self-criticism, introspection. Your awareness is developed. Introspection makes your inner voice louder and louder. Introspection will give life to your inner voice, and your inner voice in turn will give life to you. And this one process which links the past, the present and the future, practice religiously on a daily basis. In fact, let me have the audacity to say this. If you can discover this inner guru in your life, introspection, you don't need an outer guru at all in life. That guru will carry you through. And man has been designed with this ability where you can lift yourself by your own awareness. And that's all you require. And once you start practicing introspection, then the context of all the discourses you attend, speeches you listen to, books you read, everything becomes irrelevant. Only then, draw a line to your past. Believe today is the beginning of a new future. Set a new perspective to your life. Let go of what's gone. Be grateful to all that you have learned. Believe you are not here to be a caterpillar, but you can be a butterfly. Expand the bandwidth of your perception with which you look at your life. Commit yourself with immediate effect to some small beginnings. Incremental improvement. Sustain the progress for monumental possibilities through consistent, directed, self-motivated effort. Through the process of introspection that I practice at the end of the day, and thereby link my past, present, and future. And thereby, I will throw myself into this furnace called life in that faith that he is watching me and not negate this possibility that I have descended into a human form with the possibility that I can ascend into divine proportions. And that will be a great gift that you can give yourself, for in the lift of every man, a part of humanity is also lifted in the entire process. And that will be our dedication to have come together in the hall of Gurudev on the day of Mahatma. Together, one generation worked together and gave us independent India. You and me can be the next generation that we can work together and truly put India on top of the world. Together, let's do it. My future, your future, India's future, and the future of the world begins in our own way today. For today is the beginning of a new future. Loving you all so much. Thank you.
Thank you.